So how to really implement? Normally, we in academic institutions, we solve the problems which can be solved and published. We don't solve the problems which should be solved and which is the necessity of society. You please remember these two sentences. What is that we are solving here? Which need to be solved and which can be solved, right? So in order to understand the problem, I held 20 workshops in the state of Maharashtra and Gujarat and met housewives, 20 in number each time, and tried to understand their problem, what exactly they do. Because the improved cook stove program has been ongoing for 70 years and there has been no dent really in improving this. So what the housewives were required, I will not tell you the total story, but the first thing that they told me was the whatever new cook stoves are there, there is a standard quantity of fuel and that is not desired. One time we may need to make one cup of tea, some other time 10 guests will come and then we have to make cook much more quantity and standard quantity. Whatever may be the design of cook stove, and the best one is of, please try to understand, the cook stove, the best one is made by, right? The only problem as usual with foreign people, costing 4,500 per cook stove. When I ask these housewives, what is the money you can afford to buy a cook stove? They said between 500 and 700. We definitely don't want free. This is very, very important. We are ready to pay 500, and that 4,500 was beyond the scope. But even, and this cook stove, something else, if I name something, then you, though it is truth, this also you remove. Yeah. So they corrode, that is the second problem. So then our students, they did research for 3 years, and for every problem that we take for implementation, we don't look for a person or industry after innovation is done. We innovate it together. Then there is no problem. And up till now, more than 6 lakh cook stoves have been sold. 6 lakh cook stoves, which are in operation. I wanted to include more number of slides. How to take it to society? There are many. We as engineers and scientists, we are not really capable of talking to people and society. So we should always collaborate with social scientists. And all the inventions, they should be implemented through social entrepreneurship. Somebody should create the generated value by innovation. It should be shared in such a way that particular entrepreneur is able to take it to society. I'm telling you very briefly, but I had 5-6 slides in order to implement anything in society. Right? That is a different ballgame altogether. Next slide. But now we have been able to reach 36% to 40%, but see the automobile, they from 25% to 33% to 52%, right? Now we also come to 40%, and taking it to 45%, 50%, huge scope is there. The cook stove can be, I'm going to tell you yet another method, but with 40%, the money saved is 2 lakh crores. The nation is spending or putting 2 lakh crores in cook stove and burning that kind of money because of low efficiency. And the pollution that is created and particles that which are created are killing 18 lakh women and young children. That is the intensity. Now this is the problem to be solved in the universities. And all of us are supposed to be working for chemical industry, chemical engineering, and there are more than 200. All the profits together, not only that, all the turnover of all the industries put together, chemical industry, is not 2 lakh crores. and here only profit is 2 lakh crores. So this is the problem to be solved. Right? Next slide. So this is, these are the details. So in order to prevent losses, new ceramic was created, and the ceramic in such a way that the total ceramic required, the conducting ceramic and non-conducting ceramic, the cost should be less than 50 rupees. Entire computational fluid dynamics was done. Next slide. And these are some of the plots in PhD thesis. Next slide. And you can see that the cook stove, it is yellow flame with 550, 540 temperature. You can get golden flames, 650, and about 1000 degrees. And this is a flame of cook stove, a blue flame giving 40%. Now 40% out of the 50 minutes of cooking, we are getting blue flame only for 20 minutes, not for all the time. If we get for all the time, we would have got the efficiency of 60%. So there is a huge, huge scope for applying chemical engineering, fluid mechanics, chemical reaction engineering, all the subjects, process control, whatever we teach in learn in chemical engineering is applicable here. Next slide. Flow past diverse bodies and combination of reaction engineering with fluid mechanics. And this is cooking, rice cooking, right? So if you put any vessel on the gas, put water and put solid particles of rice, there is a flow past diverse bodies. What is the reaction? Gelatinization. And what happens to every particle? It grows. Instead of shrinking core, in the earlier example which I told you in aluminium and titanium, it is expanding core model. Right? So we try to understand the kinetics of cooking, and please note that for cooking only temperature is required. No rice cooks below 74 degrees. No lentil cooks below 90 degrees, but there is no heat of reaction. No energy is required for cooking. If you raise to that temperature, the heat of reaction, either endothermic or exothermic, that is zero. So all that energy is required for preheating. Correct? So with this, a new cooker has been designed. This is the commercial product where there is an optimization in terms of flame size, how to avoid the heat losses, and how to use the principle of multiple effect evaporation for the case of cooking. Next slide. We are normally very busy in making batch processes continuous. They are very beneficial. So why not convert batch cooking into continuous cooking? And there are large number of places, particularly the places of God, like Tirupati, where 140,000 people eat at the same time. And there are many, like jails and Balwadis and Anganwadis. And then this noon food program, we feed 11 crore children at the same time in the noon. So we need huge cooking. So continuous. When we know the kinetics of cooking, and we know the residence time distribution of rice particles in the continuous cooker, and 17 minutes are required for dal and 11 minutes for, and you properly adjust this residence time. In chemical reactions, we can accept 99% conversion. Here in cooking, if 1% is uncooked, it is not acceptable. So we need to design in such a way. So now these are being practiced continuous cooker, and one overseas company, it has also taken for marketing. Next slide. So the agricultural waste, in this table it says that it is 800 million tons in the country, right? 800 million tons. Next slide. So we know biomethanation, it is known, but it is from gobar cow dung, basically from cow dung. And over a long period of 15 years, the research has been done by a company, Gangotri, to degrade anything that you see, biomass, right? Anything that is biomass. And that biomass is generated, the gas is generated clean, And in Pune, there is a station like the methane. This is now biomethane. And the costs are as follows. The we pay biomass, the farmer 3 rupees, and he grows 10 tons of agricultural residue per year and can get 30,000 rupees. He cannot get 30,000 rupees for the main crop, but for this he can get 30,000 rupees. And then we need about 4 kilograms of biowaste to make 1 kilogram of, that is 12 rupees. The investment is 15 crores for 5 tons per day capacity. That depreciation interest is 12 rupees. So 12 plus 12, 24 rupees is the cost of production. And it sells at 45 rupees. Again, social entrepreneurship and value addition is so much that one problem is solved. We wrote such a project for Department of Biotechnology, right? It was in 2008 of making alcohol, solving this problem, and we got 50 crores at that time with 30 PhD students and fellowship together with whatever is required and some equipment, the building grant as well. Next slide. So there is another process called pyrolysis, and after pyrolysis we get gas liquid solid. Pyrolysis is endothermic. Gas we burn for meeting the endothermic heat. The solid that we get, that is bioavailable carbon, and that we are using for improving the productivity of land. And my two research students, they are busy to increase whatever we are saying. Our land productivity is 3 times less. Now in some of the cases, my students are getting 3 times more than best in the world. Of course, it cannot be done everywhere. It can be done at selected locations for some time. But at least, if we increase, forget about 3 times and 5 times. We are importing lentils and oil seeds worth 80,000 crores. I'm telling you why our nation is poor. 80,000 crores. And whatever land is allocated for oil seeds, if we increase productivity by only 50%, 1.5, we don't need import. Right? So make our land more fertile, try to understand what is the meaning of fertility of the land and improve that. Next slide. So for, again, combined reaction engineering with fluid mechanics in order to make commercial size pyrolyzers. Next slide. So this was the mission of, so when I really surveyed and tried to write the project of increasing productivity, whatever is the low productivity of our country, the amount needed by the nation for eating, except oil seeds and lentils, it is sufficient. So any effort to increase in productivity may mean reducing the prices of the farm products. Therefore, we have taken this mission that increase the productivity of by 25 or 50% so that much land is available. And photosynthesis efficiency is usually 0.3 to 0.4%. Right? So we grow 10 tons per year per hectare any biomass. So can we improve photosynthesis efficiency? And the case of bamboo is fairly well known. We have done large number of experiments in growing bamboo, and we are getting 4.5%, 15 times more efficiency. That is, in place of 10 tons per year per hectare, it is now 100 tons per year per hectare. And therefore, the next slide is, our total nation's requirement is 750 million tons per oil equivalent. The equivalent land required, the biomass equivalent is 2500 million metric tons. We need 16 million hectares, which is 4.8% of the land of the country. And we can meet all the energy requirement. We wrote this project. We gave this number. We are going to solve the energy problem. And we got 50 crores. And the correspond. But prior to making such statements, there was a track record, which is very important. But and if you want to increase it 5 times the energy requirement which we wish in the next 15-20 years, then also 24% of the land is required. But with current growth rate, which is 10 tons per hectare per year, currently we will need 45% of the land. And we cannot do that. We have to have innovation before we can meet our needs with bioenergy. Next slide. So the for taking any technology to society, government interventions are not useful. Educating the masses is not useful. We must have social entrepreneurship. The new innovation, those PhD students, they themselves should make business out of it. And the research should be of that quality. Next slide. The solar energy, recently we got 65 crores for this. Next slide. What is required here? Solar energy is known for millions of years. Right? The cost per megawatt. Right? And if we bring down the cost from 18,000 rupees per meter square to less than 5,000, then we are competitive. So this plant is being built. There are good number of PhD students, and we have a grant of 65 crores. Next slide. What is, see, this is an academic institution, and ours is also academic. We also publish. Right? So on the basis of that, and there is a very high impact factor, more than 15 or 20, I think, Nature publication. Next slide. So in atomic energy, we have our natural uranium is about 160 tons per year. And it can sustain atomic power plant of 5,000 megawatt only. But whenever the fuel is spent, the spent fuel is more valuable than the starting uranium. It has plutonium. So you develop nice technologies for plutonium, and that is called plutonium-based reactors are called fast-breeder reactors. When that fuel is spent, you get the spent mass, which is even more valuable. And then you have the enriched uranium, and you mix it with thorium, which we have abandoned. For 2,000 years, we have enough thorium with us. So we wrote up the separation of plutonium from uranium, and then the enriched uranium, the liquid-liquid extraction, the dissolution, all the unit operations that we learned, the chromatographic separation, the crystallization. And we took 45 problems from atomic energy for solving. They gave us 100 crores, 100 PhD positions. Our nation is poor. And we need to be innovative, all academic institutions, and we should solve the problems which need to be solved. Okay. Next slide. And in order to implement anything, even in industry, there has to be scientific temper. And therefore, I'm wearing one more hat. I'm president of a trust called Marathi Vidyan Parishad to have improved scientific temper of the society. Maybe I'll speak about it sometime later. We talk about the only win-win situations. And when we did hydrogenation or implemented these, when I wanted to build 400, hostel of 400 students, or for faculty members 40, 50, or a laboratory for 4 lakh square feet, we never go to government. If I have benefited industry this much, then you keep on collecting money. Then all these are in the laboratory, everything, all the space. Not only that, 100 crore worth sophisticated equipment, all of them. Because of the, so normally we talk about when such so many things are implemented, first win is deployment of technologies and creation of wealth for industry and society. That is first win. We get taxes to the government because the turnover has increased, creation of new jobs, and 1 million new jobs have been created, and this has been written by the government that how many jobs have been created by ICT. Next slide. Funding to the institution, 100 PhD fellowships with operating expenses from atomic energy, 100 PhD students, for process intensification. This is for private industry. 30 PhD students for biotechnology. So first win, second win, third win. Royalty, awards, honors, recognitions to the faculty. This is third win. High quality education to the students, which is our primary objective. Here, as a teacher, if you ask me out of these wins which you like, there is absolutely no question. I'm working for only one win, that the students must get very high quality education in terms of solving the problems to be solved and really solve them up to the end and implement them in the society. Next slide. And we need to institutionalize, right? We should select as an institution some four, five core areas and solve the problems. All these were, so what was the result? When I retired, all the fees collected was forming 10% of our income. 10% of all the government grant, which was sufficient for paying all the salaries of faculty and non-teaching staff and all the faculty put together, that was meeting 10%. And 80% was entirely external revenue generation. 80%. And all the PhD students, out of 150 PhDs intake every year, the government supported were 17. All others were supported by industry. Next slide. I think we need to be careful. There are a large number of rankings, and we go behind rankings, and we tend to forget what are our national priorities. And this is what is happening with our renowned institutions. They are behind the ranking, and we need to be among 10 in the world, among 100 in the world, and we try to do what the world is wanting, and we forget our own national, and we need to be very, very careful. Most important, this I have written and I will write any number of times, that we as a teacher, what is important is education to the students. Let nation benefit, but the students getting benefit is the most important to my heart. Next slide. So my dear students, innovate for a change. That was my first one. And all of us can do it. All, each and everyone has an ability to innovate. What is required? The clarity of purpose, what is that we have taken? The commitment and hard work. I said in the morning, no problem is unsolvable, but no problem is simple. Right? So huge perseverance is required, patience is required. And out of all these qualities, according to me, what is most important is humbleness. If you are accomplished and if you are not humble, then no innovation will come out of you. You need to be humble at that time. The balance between self and society, I think this is important. If 1 lakh rupees per year is the, and if our salary is more than 10 lakh or 15 lakh per year, and poor nation is paying us, then what is our mass balance? What is our energy balance? This week. And whenever we students, we talk in hostels, what is that we wish to give, do in future, we talk about salaries, air-conditioned cars. It's very simple. Going abroad is very simple. You will get tired of going abroad later on. What is required is talk about only innovativeness and building the nation. That should be the talk among the students. And we keep on spending time. Our time efficiency as a nation is 3%. And I'm telling you, you take a diary and after every half an hour, you really write what constructive thing I did in last half an hour. And you, at the end of the month, you'll find constructive things you did only for 3% of the time. Right? So my final message is, never complain, smile all the time, and be time efficient. Thank you so much.
We'll come to you. Those are what are the cost of those cookers?
750.
18 crore families who are using cookstoves and 6 lakh have been sold. The amount of innovations required in social market. The huge scope. The problems per million population in India are maximum in the world. So you have huge number of opportunities, and what we are good for, our level of justice and injustice, how do we spend time? We have large number of court cases, and my survey says that the number of court cases in India per million population are highest in the world. So everybody feels that he is injustice. If somebody doesn't get promotion, he feels so bad, he makes himself unhappy, family unhappy, and the entire world is ruined for him. Just for one proposal. There are N number.
I have the largest deposits of chlorine in the world, and these reactors are actually efficient than uranium based.
But you said thorium.
Yes, sir.
You said titanium, and you name anything, and we are slow.
No, sir, I meant thorium.
You meant thorium.
Yes, sir.
Name anything in this world, and where we are Indians, we are slow. That's what is the main message that I am giving. We need to.
Uranium as a fuel in US, or I don't know about India, but they push these researchers back, the ones based on thorium, because it'll kind of destroy their existence.
I don't believe this. I work 100% in atomic energy. I don't believe this. If you are stubborn from within, no country can press you in the world. You can defeat any country if you are so perseverant and so determined.
I'm afraid we need to let him have his school. I've heard him before, so you have to thank him. Okay, thanks.
We are privileged to hear Professor Santosh Kumar Gupta to present a memento to our distinguished speaker.
Say on behalf of all my colleagues that we all feel very lucky today that we attended this motivating and informative lecture on innovate to transform prosperity through science and technology. In this lecture, Professor J.B. Joshi elaborated the possibility of having prosperity through science and technology. Sir has given many examples of success stories of social entrepreneurship. I believe that this will certainly motivate young minds present here. I formally thank Professor J.B. Joshi for very kindly accepting our invitation and giving us this excellent talk. I also wish to thank our Chancellor, Dr. S.J. Chopra, our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Deependra Kumar Jha, Dr. Kamal Bansal, Dean Academic Development and Innovation, School of Engineering, our Director, Dr. Suresh Kumar, for their blessings and support for this program. Well, an event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels started rolling months ago, all thanks to
Dr. Santosh Kumar Gupta, who literally ran between departments on Friday and Saturday due to last minute uncertainty. I wish to thank our admin department, our finance department for their hard work. Finally, I once again thank everyone gathered here and do not want to stand between you and your lunch further. Thank you.